So a few of the highlights that we talked about, one of the first questions was what kind of resonated for you. And a lot of us didn't really realize the lack of participation from women as it related to politics and getting involved in that type of thing. We also talked about even how to find the balance to even do such a thing, how to balance the family and get involved and do all of these things that we would like to do. I want Ms. Erin shared with us that it was possible for her because she had a husband that was very supportive and he assisted in picking up the children while she was over here and even keeping the children involved in the entire process. And so if we're going to change, that's one of the things we have to do is to start with the young ones and develop them and grow them in the way of the change. She also talked about promoting, putting her girls in team sports because that's what the guys did. So they're not so, you know, emotional when the attacks come and they know how to handle them and address them. We also talked about seeking mentorship outside of the workplace, finding someone that's doing what you're doing, that you wanna do, and that's doing it well to help you navigate through all of the challenges that you're going to face. And then calling it out. So when you see those all, we kind of talked about all male panels and how there are people putting those panels out on the internet. And so, you know, exposing that, okay, women can do this too, and let us in. And lastly, getting involved with politics, even on the legislation level, knowing what bills are out there so that you can fight them. Because we kind of talked a little bit about the Monsanto Corporation and how they're able to pass bills because we're not aware of them. So they don't have to label their foods as genetically modified because guess what? We don't even know that they're even pushing that certain bill. So we just have to get involved.
At our table, what resonated with us, Fawn mentoring the kids and her genuine concerns, Ricky, how important it was to support each other, amazing. How Erin worked in politics and how two of them came back into the community in which they lived to contribute back after their small festering out in the pasture. Did anything surprise them? I mentioned that I, as an early supporter of Hillary Clinton, I was surprised. I never thought about it in that she was much more experienced than President Obama at the time, and yet we were so much more, it just surprised me, but yeah. And our involvement with social media, how connected we are. And also, it just, a lot of different conversations centered around, we have here a press corps for the White House, as part of the press corps, and Joanne Rowe in her early days in television and radio, and how, when in the old days, not the old days. Well, but how those days where women truly were only what their men were, and et cetera, and no, you were supposed to stay home and cook and knit, and how she, you know, went through some barriers in Colorado and got a following.
Okay, here we go. Remember
the right to vote? Remember what happened when women got the vote? So black men or women, so it's always been that kind of equation. Who's the table?
I had the distinct pleasure and honor of being a facilitator for this table, and I think that what resonated with us as we were talking about it was just the amazing amount of diversity there is in the room. First of all, queer. There's a camera. Yes, I know. So that took up part of our time, I apologize. So, anyway, that we have this extremely wonderful diversity, and I think I have to recognize also, I know that the word dame is not usually considered complimentary, But when you're considering the real strength and power and political anchors that we have in this community through the leadership of so many folks who are in this room today, not today very many, but Angie and Dee Dee, I'm really incredulous. We are so honored to have you here among so many of others of us who are obviously care enough to be here. But it was very, that was part of the diversity consideration that everybody noticed. Everybody was also surprised to hear that women had to be asked 9 times. Mm-hmm. And that we need to be asking more. We need to be promoting and developing existing organizations like the Women's Lobby and the Women's Chamber of Commerce, and use those as places that we can grow more leaders and more folks who would consider running for office. Our daughters need more role models, and they need to be helped become better role models. And it's remarkable how the Native tribes are invisible here. But it was noted that there is going to be a new hotel in Las Vegas that will have a Native American theme, and it will have a cultural center here that hopefully will be well promoted and be something that we can all be proud of. As far as the surprises, it was interesting that in 1951, I won't say who mentioned this, women were really in the back seat. But now they've led in voluntary and in other ways and encouraged to give back to the community, and we're hoping that their wonderful heritage is going to be the legacy that's going to be instilled in the next generation. And as far as what has changed after today, we're hoping that the leadership combining business background and volunteer leaders from women in our community are going to build future political strength for women in our community.
Good, almost end of morning. And I'm gonna work a little backwards with ours, because I think that what I got most from our table is that we need to plant a seed. And Teresa mentioned that word, and I thought that was a very powerful word, because we also had someone at our table saying that as a child, they were told that they could not do something. And as an adult, we're now told that women have to be told 6 to 8 times that they have before they even run for office. So if we plant the seeds when the children are younger about the power that they have and whatever it is they choose to do, and as you said, Ricky, that they can change their mind, but we have to give them the authority to change their mind. And if we plant the seeds early enough, that will definitely happen, because we have some powerful women at the table that I know and don't know. And even the conversation at our table led a lot around Vaughn and the power that she actually has, and we were all like mesmerized by all that she poured into us, but that we had no idea that all this was in our community. And how do we not know this if we are residents of this community? So we have to rally around each other and plant seeds for the women that we want to run in office, plant seeds in the girls that are around us, and plant seeds no matter what side of the party line that you are on.
There were points made by all the panel speakers that resonated with all of us, and we went from discussing on just as high school students and coming up, not knowing about these women organizations that are designed to help empower women and help women to progress in life, and going back and doing that now. Then we also talked about just how shocking it was to learn that as our nation picked a black man over a woman who was so politically experienced. And then we also talked about, as women, how we have to sometimes be overqualified for a position just to be considered equal in our jobs. And I know I just had to go get a master's degree because I work in an engineering department, and just to try to feel like I had that potential to be promoted. And then we also talked about how we're going to take, you know, just learning about the Native American culture and how it's matrilineal. And in our culture, women are the decision makers and the strategists and the leaders, and how we can implement that back in our lives and our culture now going forward.
So again, I'd like to thank everyone for participating in all the ways that you participated this morning. And now as we leave here, let's go out and do something.